Welcome back to the most hackingest place you can ever hack. Many things have tried to hack, but we don't hack anything besides dinos. This is Hack the Dino, our gaming cast, where we bring you the past, present, and future of video games news, previews, and discussions. I am Ben Rosenthal, one of the... Jesus Christ, did you cough up a lung there? What was that?
Pelican fluff.
Bloody hell! Wow!
Came out of nowhere, sorry about that.
Holy smoke! We were 30 seconds into the recording.
Yeah.
You had plenty of time beforehand.
No, I didn't.
When we're not sneezing out our left hemisphere of our brain...
I think I popped a vein.
We are talking about video games, but we also have a very special show that goes on afterwards for some Patreons over at hackthedino.com. Just sign up for any level and you can get an extra bonus episode where we talk about anything that comes to our heads. And as we are not in the studio this week to record an episode because real life finds a way...
It does.
To sneeze out your lung.
And then it eats you and learns to open doors.
We have cobbled together... A classic dino morph. When I say classic, it's like, yeah, this one.
Classic.
This one's got a good runtime. We can get a podcast out of this.
That one was weird. Let's do that one.
And we're putting it up on the main feed. I believe Braden's with us for this one because Anto was unwell that week. And we are talking about movies.
I think I had a big bat of movies. Mm-hmm. And we were going through them.
We were.
Just looking at some cool movies. I was actually, I believe I was having a cull.
You were.
Yep. And it was offering you guys some film.
Yeah, I think I got the complete series of Cowboy Bebop off you.
You did, on DVD, didn't you? Because I had really it twice.
Cool. Yeah, and then I got Jazz to get Happy Gilmore because I like that movie.
Sicko.
That's a good film.
Yeah, no, it's great.
Happy Gilmore is
a good film. Shooter
McGavin. Holds up. Holds up.
It does. You know what? Didn't hold up? Billy Madison.
Correct.
Did not hold up.
Apart from the lady who played Veronica. Who did she marry?
I don't know, but none of that film held up.
I think the lady who... Because she also played Sonya Blade in the original Mortal Kombat film.
Mm-hmm.
She married, I think, a tennis player and just went, eh, well, I'm done.
That still doesn't have anything to do with the fact that I said that movie does not hold up.
Why doesn't it hold up?
Have you watched it lately?
Not lately.
No, I don't.
Right. Does Mallrats hold up? Because I used to love Mallrats.
Yes, it does.
Okay, good. None of Kevin Smith's latest films hold up, though. Oh, boy. They are...
I haven't seen any of them.
Big old stinkers. Big old stinkfest.
Chasing Amy held up.
Chasing Amy is a good film.
It's a great film, I believe.
Very well written.
Have you seen Clerks 3? I haven't seen Clerks 3.
I've not seen Clerks 3
yet. I only recently saw Clerks 2.
Jay and Silent Bob Strike Back was an awful cluster of a film.
No, no good.
Anto, you want to chip in with that?
Yeah, Clerks 3 is not as good as either of the previous two.
Clerks 1 is sensational.
Yeah, Clerks 2 was really good.
Clerks 2 was surprisingly good, I think. Mm. Rosario Dawson is fantastic, as she is in everything that she does.
Ahsoka.
Yeah. Man, I tell you what, I've been getting majorly into Star Wars again.
I thought you were going somewhere else with that, and that's okay.
Star Wars, really, really good. The Expanded Universe.
Started Andor.
Oh, really? I've watched the first episode. I really liked it.
I will do that also again, because I watched that a couple of weeks ago, and I want to watch it again before I watch episode 2.
See, the problem is I have to wait for Jazz to be available to watch it, because we're watching them together. Did
no,
you watch
don't.
Jedi Tales yet?
No.
Tales of the Jedi?
No.
Really cool. Really good.
You know, you don't have to wait. You can just pretend you haven't seen it and watch it again.
Well, I might do that. I was going to go, oh, don't say that. She'll know. And I was like, no, she doesn't watch this. Who gives
she
a crap?
She doesn't watch this and she ain't here and I don't have her Instagram. Oh, wait, yes, I do. Might tell her.
Ooh. And she'll go, did you watch it? And I'll go, no. Are you lying? Yes.
And she'll be like, I know you're lying. You're like, how? And she's like, your lips are moving.
Yeah, good one.
Four clicks in the shape of a Z.
What does that mean?
I don't know. I saw cool kids do it once
right.
in 1992.
Sup, we're old. Anyway, here's a show. Put it in your face. Hello, it's us. We're here, we're there, we're everywhere. We're in your care, we're on your chair. You can find us in a boat. And we are friendly with a goat.
Whoa. Well, you know, it is cold.
I do not like green eggs and ham. I do not like...
Green eggs or spam.
Sure. Hi, everyone. This is Ben and Floppy. We've been cel-shaded.
I was about to say, I like that I look cel-shaded. I kind of dig it.
No, so do you want to know the worst thing?
Yeah. What?
Look at the text.
Hey!
It's all backwards.
We're in a dream.
So for the gang in the Discord, because it's treating it as a virtual camera, it flips the image.
Nice.
So on the recording, if anyone wants to watch this dynamo afterwards, they will see it like normal. But for those in the Discord, we are reversed and look a little weird.
I'm left-handed now.
Hello, stranger.
So what are we doing with the old dynamo?
Oh, they can see it normally.
Yeah, wow. Oh, okay.
Can I?
So it's just us that see things backwards. Do we look cel-shaded?
Checks out.
Yeah. Do we look cel-shaded to you guys?
Unfocus this person.
Oh, Mike, do you play games inverted?
Let me just go under the table.
Stupid joke. Okay, cool. Apparently it's fine.
All right, Dynamo. What are we doing? We're going to do some movies and check out the Patreon Fantasy Critic?
So I brought a whole bunch of DVDs and Blu-rays over to Ben's for the guys to go through because I'm going to get rid of a lot. And I thought I'd give them first crack. But Ben and I were looking through them and were like, there's some cool stuff in here.
Yep. I grabbed Cowboy Bebop, the complete series, and I grabbed a sealed Blu-ray of Close Encounters of the Third Kind.
And Jazz grabbed a whole lot more.
She certainly did.
Happy Gilmore. She grabbed Happy Gilmore.
No, I grabbed Happy Gilmore.
You grabbed Happy Gilmore.
That was one I was umming and ahhing about, and then I saw it there. I went, can I see this anywhere else? No. Will I want to watch it again? Probably. All right, I'll grab it.
They were all bought, Michael Towns.
I grabbed a Blu-ray of Ben Affleck's Daredevil.
Sealed.
And a Blu-ray double pack of the early 2000s Fantastic Four movies.
Yes, you did.
So I'm going to sneak those onto my friend's shelf.
Oh, tell that story.
And I'm going to sneak them onto the shelf of my friend.
I love that story.
Who has a gigantic Blu-ray collection.
So your friend, so is it Alex?
Yes.
Is it Alex's shelf?
Film connoisseur.
He has a massive
film connoisseur. Hates Ben Affleck's Daredevil?
Hates Ben Affleck's Daredevil.
Just hates Ben Affleck? Or?
Oh, I just think it's a shit movie. The best thing... Okay, well, we're off Twitch, so it's fine. The best thing to come out of Ben Affleck's Daredevil was the fact that Colin, his...
Farrell?
His sex tape came out while they were filming that.
I was in that. on Twitch.
Did you guys know that?
No,
I didn't know that was during that.
No, he's quite a well endowed man.
Yeah, Boozer.
Just
you can tell it's during Daredevil because he's bald.
Did you know that that's why the horse in Toy Story is named Boozer after Colin Farrell and his character and the sex tape? Did you know that
his horse
really?
Yeah, that's why they named the horse Boozer. He's well endowed.
Bullshit.
I commend the improv there. That was good.
Is that improv or is this real?
That you think I'm improving. That's great. I'd love that you think I can come up with that.
See, I'm confused, which is why I'm not diving off into laughter. Because if that is real...
I'm googling it.
Think of the timeline.
Fact check, Braden.
Toy Story.
Actually, don't fact check that on my computer.
Okay.
But yeah.
Daredevil.
That was one of the in jokes. And then there was like, you know, they had a whole bunch of adult jokes.
Floppy's really good at this.
Really?
I'm great at Baldi Dash, man. At that.
Toy Story 2, which I should have known off the top of my head because it was the first film I ever saw in cinemas, released 1999. Daredevil is 2003.
I'm really good at Boulder Dash.
Really good. That was great.
So I do it to my staff all the time, that sort of shit. They've now called me out for gaslighting.
Oh my God.
You are very good, sir.
Yeah.
Very, very good.
Yeah.
Why are you...
It's a blessing and a curse.
To have me... I don't want to toot my own horn like Colin Farrell does, but...
Colin Farrell.
For me to bite on something like that, that's...
You're going to say it with conviction.
You've done well. You've done very, very well. All right.
We should play Baldur Dash one day. It's where you have to write bullshit and convince other people it was real.
Well, see, I can usually do that, but me wanting to laugh takes over. Anyway.
The stream can't see this.
Oh, Brayden, why?
Because he's...
Again, why my computer?
I'm not actually going to do it.
I was really hoping you were. I've seen it. It's amazing. Oh, a bullseye skin for Fortnite so he converses to foes Green Goblin. Battle of the this. Huge dicks.
Slappers only.
You guys were saying before about the whole Fight Club.
Yes.
Like the Fight Club, like Tyler Durden thing, right?
Yeah. Yes.
Oh, we should probably invite Anto into this.
He's in this channel, isn't he?
Yeah, he should be.
Yeah, he can join this if he wants to.
Maybe we should add him. Just
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Okay, I'm closing that now.
That's what he wants you to think.
All right, so like that Dylan and Townsend have no idea what you were doing. He was flashing up pictures of Colin Farrell.
Colin Farrell's little Farrell.
Onto our screen in front of us so that we see it.
Yeah. All of it.
And that's width.
Baby's arm holding an apple.
It turned out Brayden had OBS open and pressed the stream button.
Streaming straight to Twitch.
And banned. Anyway, we got a few other
That was just normal bullseye. How dare you?
No, there's no such thing as normal bullseye anymore.
With that target on, you can't really tell. Like when you flash it on the screen like that.
Yeah, there's a really weird part of that film where he sits there and he gets like,
oh wait, I can actually show this on.
It's really sexual, the way that he does it. It's quite gross. You know what? I really quite enjoyed Ben Affleck's Daredevil.
Did you?
Like, I don't think it's anywhere near as good as old mate
Charlie Cox.
Very excited.
I never understood
Charlie
why everyone hated it so much.
I really should go back and watch it again. It's mainly the costume, honestly.
It's mainly the musical soundtrack.
God, look at that.
Evanescence.
See, like, that actually doesn't look that... What's wrong with
look
that
at,
costume?
Yeah, because the difference is, this is a piece of art. That's concept art. This is the actual thing.
Yeah.
That looks shocking.
I mean, think of it. It's a product of its time as well. You think of everything else that was out at that time. I found it weird that...
You know what else was out that time and was an excellent film?
What?
Blade.
Blade had some pretty dodgy special effects. Did you ever see the footage of when the guy at the end of the blade was going to turn into like a blood monster?
Yes.
Terrible.
Oh, excellent.
Speaking of films.
Did you ever see Triple H in Blade?
You should see Kick Ass.
Man, Triple H was in Blade. Blade 3. Blade Trinity.
Yeah. Oh, he was in 3. Yep, yep.
You made a goddamn Pomeranian vampire.
And now he runs WWE.
Look, if you haven't seen Kick Ass.
He looks like he walked off the set of being like not good enough of an actor to play Sabretooth in the X-Men films.
Yes.
Well, this was the film that people decided he wasn't going to be a Hollywood star.
Yeah, funny that.
Yeah, funny that. That was the third Blade film and he played a big burly vampire.
Ah, bless Blade Trinity.
Apparently, like Wesley Snipes was the worst person to work with on that film ever. And on many other films that he's done.
Well, I know Ryan Reynolds didn't get along with him terribly well.
I don't think anyone did.
Mm. Well, by
apparently
then
he was just high all the time.
I'm so excited for Mahershala Ali to be Blade.
Oh, yeah. I'm so excited never to have to think about the Eternals again.
Oh, poor Eternals.
Should we?
Don't worry, they're making a second
should
one.
Should we
apparently.
Actually talk to the guys about the stuff we're going to talk to?
Oh, yeah, yeah, cool. Yeah, good idea.
I got Kick-Ass.
Yeah.
You should watch Kick-Ass. Have you watched Kick-Ass?
Yep. I laughed so hard in the cinema when I saw it.
It is amazing. Imagine, I don't know if you guys haven't seen it. I bet Townsley's seen it. Dylan, I don't know if you've seen this or not. A normal everyday kid decides he wants to be a superhero. Why is there no superheroes? You just got to be one, right? It's super violent. It's super not PC in a lot of playing. Some of Nicolas Cage's best work ever.
It stars Quicksilver and Quicksilver.
True. It has both Quicksilvers.
The two Quicksilvers. The one from Fox and the one from Marvel. So Kick-Ass is the Quicksilver from the Marvel universe.
I'm trying to think of where the other guy is in it.
It's his best friend.
What?
One of his best friends is the other Quicksilver.
No.
Yeah.
Is it really?
Yeah, that's why in WandaVision, when he's there playing Quicksilver, she looks at something and goes, like, no, one of her sons says, oh, that'd be Kick-Ass. And she goes, Kick-Ass?
Yeah.
I couldn't make it through WandaVision.
There he is.
Oh, my God, it is too. Wow, yeah. I'd never put that together. Yeah, Townsie's gone like, yeah, pre-American Horror Story. It sure is. Wow, that was unreal. I love Nick Cage in this, Big Daddy.
Yeah.
Look at him.
Did you read the graphic novel at all?
I sure did. And number two.
Yeah.
But yeah, Kick-Ass. Worthwhile watch.
Yeah. I like the jetpack scene.
Oh, the jetpack scene.
That's where I lost it.
Wait,
that's
hold up. Mark Strong was in Kick-Ass?
Yeah.
I don't remember that.
Yeah, wasn't he the big baddie dude?
Excellent. I love Mark Strong. He's great.
You should talk about... Which one do you know anything about? You talk about Kickboxer.
All right. I don't know much about Kickboxer, but I do know much about Bloodsport.
Same movie,
but Bloodsport, which is the one that came before this, which was Jean-Claude Van Damme's martial arts debut, it was his first movie where he was the main character, actor.
Yeah, because he was in No Retreat, No Surrender as his first one, I think.
Yeah, but he wasn't the main, was he?
No, he was the bad guy. He was the main bad guy.
Yeah. So this is, I don't care about this one. I'm going to talk about Bloodsport. Yeah,
this scene though. He's got drunk dance fighting in this scene. It's so good. I literally watched this the other day.
Jean-Claude Van Damme is, you know, it's not his fault. I'm more opposed to Frank Dux, who the story is supposedly based on. And if you go down the wormhole that is Frank Dux on YouTube, finding out about all the lies he's told and people debunking the lies, it is phenomenal what someone could get away with just lying.
Pre-internet,
pre-MMA, pre-mixed martial arts.
Wait for the splits.
Splits are everywhere. Sorry, and then there's a little bum rise.
Is his tank top singlet thing got like clips?
I believe so.
Like he can clip it apart?
I think it's more to the point it lengthens. I think it's like a pair of braces.
What the fuck?
Jean-Claude Van Damme.
Is this the whole set? Yeah, there we go.
Jesus.
And the wiggle.
Has to be in every film. But yeah, Frank Dux.
It's in his contract.
Look up Frank Dux. He's a real piece of shit.
This movie, however, is... look at that. Just like many, many, many Van Damme films. His brother gets hurt and he enters a competition to avenge him.
Yep.
And has to learn... Well, in this kind, he learns Muay Thai.
I believe Jean-Claude Van Damme was also a ballet dancer in his youth.
And he works it into a lot of the movies. He's in this one as well.
Mm.
And in Double Team, where he plays two characters.
And then there was a movie, Brandon, you might know. It's a French film, because Jean-Claude Van Damme's obviously French. But he plays himself, and it's a real...
JCVD.
Yes, that one.
Yeah.
Apparently, exceptionally good film.
So good.
Exceptionally well acted. Like, it was nominated for a Best Foreign Film Oscar or something. Mm. There's a soliloquy halfway through where he's just talking to the camera, and apparently it's one of the best performances, clearly of his life.
Well, he's playing himself, and he's kind of taking the piss out of himself.
Yeah, yeah, this one, this here, I think, is
the soliloquy. Part where he's like, "Guys, I'm 42. I can't do it in one take anymore."
That's depressing, isn't it? Yeah.
God damn.
But yeah, that it's a movie I want to see because I like character pieces where people actually have a connection to it.
Mm. Like, your favorite film is Todd Phillips' Jericho.
No, that's Chris Jericho. He breaks the walls down.
Right. My next film is Ricochet.
Ba-doo! He's also a good wrestler.
This was the first film where I saw... his name's just gone around in my head. John Lithgow as a bad guy.
Oh, he's an exceptionally good bad guy.
See, I saw this before, well before Cliffhanger or anything like that. This has got Denzel Washington
and Dexter, season 3.
Yeah. Denzel Washington as a cop and John Lithgow as the bad guy. And he destroys the cop's life, like pulls it apart, has everyone against him. It's so good. Gets him hooked on drugs and everything. Oh, yeah. It is very 80s, so it is very over-the-top violent, like early 90s and 80s. John Lithgow with, like, red hair.
Out of the code law thing.
Yeah.
That? He
gets shot in the knee.
Something else.
And there's one part where he ties books to his ankle to bend his knee to just sort of regain mobility. It's terrifying. But yeah, Ricochet. John Lithgow as a bad guy. I'll watch any movie that's got John Lithgow in it, let alone John Lithgow as a bad guy. So good.
Next is The Saint.
Townsie has seen this. Man, The Saint is cool.
It's got Val Kilmer in it before he was Batman.
Correct.
And then, of course, after he was Batman, his career died.
Yes.
It's based on a TV show.
Have you seen this?
Years ago. Mm. But it is based on a TV show.
Yeah, it is. Roger Moore was the original of The Saint.
That's right.
Was in, yeah,
oh, was that name? Editing.
Whoa, who oh. is it?
He does an Australian accent in this movie, and it's really good.
Yeah?
Yeah. So Val Kilmer, when he plays many different characters.
Val Kilmer can act.
Man, yeah, this is...
He can really act.
Is this Val Kilmer doing a serious reboot of Monsters of Disguise?
Essentially, yes. Turtle.
Yeah, he's a spy.
Here for the turtle.
It's got Bad Russian Man, who's always Bad Russian Man in every movie that needs a Bad Russian Man. Him. There you go. Mm. But it's actually, he does a really good job playing all the different, you know, identities that he takes on board, all named after saints.
All with the same face. Who would have thought?
Yes. But no. Yeah, and he does a wicked Australian accent in it. Right there, actually, in that scene.
He says, "Fucking blimey!"
This is bloody bullshit, mate.
Oh, my God.
Oh, Val Kilmer was amazing in Willow as Mad Mardigan. All right. I'll talk about Basic.
All right.
This is a fantastic film. I was trying to get Brayden to watch it. Oh, Jesus. Not that one that Brayden's showing, I might add. That is Garth from Wayne's World.
This movie came out on September 11, is that no. right?
No. So the story behind this film
it's is so that bad.
The day they shot this scene was September 11th. 2001.
Oh,
Jesus.
He was in costume when they held a minute of silence after hearing the news. So bad.
I wonder why his career just died in the ass after this.
Oh, bless.
Anyway.
Yeah. Basic, however, has a cast like John Travolta, Connie Nielsen, Samuel L. Jackson, from the same director as Die Hard and The Predator.
Nice.
Predator. This is one of those ones where you an event has happened.
Now, Floppy, which one of these is it?
What?
Did you look up Predator?
No, I looked up Basic 2009.
Did you do Basic 2009 trailer? It's none of those.
It's not the cool car?
It's none of those.
What the shit are you doing, YouTube?
Maybe you should just write trailer. but you get to see is after the effects of the after the fact of the events have happened.
Do you want to, did they get fourth place in the Russian aerobic competition?
I believe so. And
you're ready for quiz?
People are being interviewed or interrogated, and you are watching their version of events as they tell it. And then you'll see the same thing like a number of times, but slightly different due to different version events. Very, very cool. Yeah, that top one there. Military base. Yeah. John Travolta is an investigator. Very cool, very smart. Before he was a bit weird.
That's Samuel L. Jackson, MF.
Samuel L. motherfucking Jackson.
We'll say Face Off. Good movie.
Oh, Face Off. Great movie.
Speed Racer. Good movie.
Speed Racer.
Wonderful also movie. Good movie.
But yeah.
You know, it's not a wonderful movie. Piranhas 3D.
Oh, Piranha 3D.
It has piranhas.
Ving Rhames.
They're in 3D.
Christopher Lloyd's in that.
Christopher Lloyd's good. It's not James Cameron's directorial debut.
No.
As I found out earlier.
Cheesy remake. Lots of boobs and stuff.
Do you like boobs? Big fan of boobs.
There's a few of them. Oh, there's even a dude gets his dick chewed off by a piranha.
Wow.
Jerry O'Connell actually plays a character based on the guy that ran the Girls Gone Wild videos and stuff.
Warning.
But he does it on purpose. Like, he really overplays it. He's fantastic.
I will say, I only know that reference because of the comedy button. I don't think I've ever even seen a Girls Gone Wild video.
No.
I just know that they start with the warning.
Warning. Yeah, Ving Rhames and Spring Break. You know, carnage and mayhem will ensue.
Looks awful.
Oh, it is terribly awful, but it's a great Sunday afternoon flick when you're hungover.
Oh, this is a very 2000s movie, hey?
Yes.
Oh, wait, it's not that 2000s. There was one black guy.
Yeah, he gets his legs bitten off.
Oh, you missed last show, Braden. Mr. A-Game and I, because Jazz was controlling the show.
Oh, look at this classy cinematography. Are you ready? Look at this. Oh, just... Oh, take it to a French film festival. Look at that.
Bite that ass.
I'm here to eat ass and I'm
and
a piranha.
Chew bubblegum and I'm all out of bubblegum.
Anyway, we ripped on Friends for about 10 minutes.
Oh, yeah, and it's got... And it's got Richard Dreyfuss
as
dressed as he is in Jaws, but with no reference to who he is.
He's just in there.
He's just playing the character Hooper from Jaws.
Hooper!
Hooper. Hooper! Here is to swimming with bow-legged women.
Hey, so,
what?
Are piranhas known for like stopping and dramatically screaming?
They're not even known for attacking people.
Yeah.
It doesn't happen. They eat dead carcasses. What were you saying happened on the last show?
Val Kilmer's career. We just, Mr. Agam and I just ripped into Friends for like 5 minutes.
Jazz would have loved
there.
That.
Yeah. No, she just sat there going, no. You go, no, really, really. Why are we watching Hulk?
I don't know. It was just in the recommended YouTube videos for some reason.
Do you know what I do like about this Hulk, though? He's the only Hulk that as he gets angrier, he actually gets bigger.
Mm.
Like, they just sort of ditched that.
Yeah. I mean, it was also the best video game they ever did.
Is that where he just, like, trashes everything?
It was Hulk Ultimate Destruction.
I actually think Eric Banner sucks, but...
Well, that's why he doesn't have a career anymore.
Look at that CG.
It's perfect.
It was wonderful. I went and saw that at the cinemas, and I was actually really good at the cinemas at the time.
Mm.
Like, I thought it looked amazing.
Yeah, at the time, yeah.
But yeah, like, it obviously doesn't stand up to today's Hulks.
That man would be dead.
He would be so dead.
Yeah.
Yeah, so he gets angry and he actually gets bigger, which is, yeah, see?
Yeah.
Which is how I always imagine the Hulk being.
That's very, like, cosmic level Hulk. Like, he can be so angry that he's, like, a planet destroyer.
Yeah.
I think Immortal Hulk plays with that a bit.
I do like that Hulk, for some reason, just decides the best way to travel is to jump.
Well, yeah.
Leaps and bounds.
He leaps.
Because he's really strong.
Yeah, but who wouldn't just run?
Hulk.
I know.
So, Hold up. I haven't watched this movie since I was a little kid. I didn't realize that the bad guy of Hulk was fucking Absorbing Man.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yep.
And he's he's been announced for what movie? He's been announced as he's coming back. He's coming back in
really?
Nick Nolte played his dad and Absorbing Man. Yeah.
Oh my god. Weird. I've not seen this movie since like 2004.
Yeah, thanks when the last person on earth saw that movie as well. Crazy. It's crazy times.
Townsend, you don't get to say you're old, mate.
Yeah.
You don't have that privilege yet.
No. You got a long way to go, buddy.
Yeah, cool movies.
Long way to go. All right, should we have a quick look at Fantasy Critic for an update?
All right, let's look at it. I have not looked at Fantasy Critic in like months. No idea what's happening.
So we're going to look at the big one? Because the...
Yeah, we already did. That was Colin Farrell.
The host Fantasy Critic is once again down to Braden and I within like...
Oh, really?
Five points of each other.
Real close.
Oh, man. What happened to me on that one?
You're still technically in the lead, but you've got all your points. Whereas Braden and I, with projected points, it's looking like...
Projected points don't count, mate.
We had this argument.
Yeah, and you were wrong. You don't look at a horse race and be like, who's winning? Or the person in the third place, because they've probably got the projected best chance of winning.
Yeah,
you're like, who's winning? Dude in front.
But you also go, oh, who's that coming along the side? Oh, watching them. Oh, what? They've overtaken. Oh, man.
Yeah, and at that point, you can say they're winning when they overtake.
Breaking news. Everything delayed till 2023. Yeah, it checks out.
And Floppy wins.
Yeah. All right, let's have a look at the old... Oh, it's the host one first?
This is the host.
All right, so...
So... The actual points at this stage. So we've got Floppy, 104.26. Floppy's in first place. Brayden's second with 85.73.
I've still got $80 left.
Yeah.
Although that was, I got screwed over. I did a few bids and it doubled all my bids. Like it took the bids twice.
You should have hit up the help people.
I got angry and then forgot about it.
Yeah, fair enough. I'm third at the moment with 85.909.
We're both on 85, just with different percentiles.
Yep. Wow. But if we go to projected, just for argument's sake, I know Floppy's against it, but just for argument's sake.
That's what possibly might happen.
8.75 versus 0.11. So we've got 8 points in it, Brayden.
Yep. It's crazy. It's so close between us.
And like this is what happened last year as well. Like you were in the lead and then right at the very end, I think I got a favorable win.
Yeah. I like that my projected points are somehow lower than the points I've actually got.
Yeah, what?
Well, because...
That one game you've got because be maths? Such a shit game.
No, because it fluctuates, remember? Like the overall score. Like your score can go up and down. So my...
But it can't go down.
Yes, it can.
How?
My Kirby, that one they released... Whatever that Kirby game was, the eating one.
Forgotten ones.
Yeah, the...
Forgotten something?
The Fall Guy ones.
Mm.
That started out at 69. It's now down to 67. Because it takes the aggregate of the score. So okay. As more reviews come out, they go up so or down.
This is a different view. Where's the dates? Is it a different view or is it just me? Because I usually look at them on my phone.
Probably because you usually...
So what have I... So Gotham Knights. Why have I... So I've still got Gotham Knights coming.
Gotham Knights still to come.
Yeah, that's your last one to come out.
Yeah. What have I gotten so far? What was I can't even read that actually.
So you missed out on
so Horizon Forbidden West.
Yep,
88, good. Yeah, Gran Turismo 7, 87, Kirby.
You had some good picks. They're all in the 80s and 70s.
Lego.
And I mean Gotham Knights. Unless 80. it's a turd.
I will Tiny's say, Tino, I thought the was more that they talk about Gotham Knights, the more interested I am in it.
Dude, yeah. I've pre-ordered the big one.
I'm very, very interested in it.
Tiny Tina, I thought was going to do a bit better, and I thought Tom Clancy would do a bit better.
But he's still got above the 70s, so it's yeah. Not. Switch Sports was surprising, but it is more of the same.
It was surprising. I was expecting that to do better.
And then you haven't got any. So I think your counter picks are okay because I don't think Advance Wars is coming out this year. Oh, Bayonetta 3 might cost you. That's out on the 20th.
Maybe that's why the projected thing is.
Yeah, that might hurt you a bit.
Yeah.
Yeah. I wonder if I can change it.
No, you're locked in.
For your counter picks?
Yeah.
Yep.
You can't ever change them?
No. Once you've picked them, you've picked them.
He just doesn't want me to.
No, you can't. Absolutely not. In fact, you don't even...
Never, actually. That's your counter pick for the rest ever, of the life.
Forever. It's crazy. Yeah. Crazy how they do that. But yeah, Bayonetta 3 is one of my picks. I think you only picked it because you didn't think it was coming out.
Yeah, sure. I didn't pick it because I thought it was going to be bad. I picked it because I thought it wasn't going to come out.
Picking a counter pick because you don't think it's going to come out this year. Brayden, what does your Patreon League one look like? Last of Us Part 1. Oh, no. Absolutely.
All right, Brayden, what is yours looking like?
Let's scroll down here.
God of War, probably going to tank.
I've got God of War coming in.
That Elden Ring sure did hurt
that
you.
That poor little Elden Ring.
Yeah, that did good. Mario and Rabbids will probably get you a few.
Yeah, I think that's going to get a couple.
I think 75 to
Midnight
80.
Suns, I don't think is going to get you much.
This one's a risk.
Mm-hmm.
This one's a big risk.
Those empty ones are a bit of a risk.
Yeah, we'll see what happens in a day and a couple hours.
Whoa! See, I've got
they're
one coming
not games
as well.
That you guys would have been on at all.
Cult of Lamb was a good call.
Yeah, that I was very
that was good.
That
I've heard good things about it.
Bam Breakfast, Stray, it's positives. Stray,
Call of Duty is probably going to do you well.
I imagine. I mean, that's like Call of Duty is just like a safe eight, isn't it?
Yeah, pretty much.
I reckon
really
Sonic
sad
Frontiers
this didn't come out.
I reckon you're going to lose points with Sonic Frontiers counterpicked.
Oh, I don't know. I think it's going to be shit.
Oh, I reckon you're wrong.
Oh, it looks so bad.
Nah, it looks so good.
Nah, they've released... Brayden, this is me talking.
Okay.
They've released a new trailer.
Okay.
And everyone keeps saying it looks empty in still photos. I'm like, it's because you're not... You're
moving.
But you're moving in the game. You're not standing still.
I know.
And just, you're moving at an incredible
pace. It's
super
unappealing to me, so...
No, same. Like, but I don't think it's going to tank. I think it'll easily beat the 70s.
See, you know what I think is going to hurt it in the review scores? Everyone is going to be comparing it to Breath of the Wild.
Yeah.
So comparing it to that, I think people are going to go, oh, like maybe give it like sevens and eights.
That's still bad for you.
I mean, it's not as bad as Last of Us Part 1.
Yeah, well, you know. And then...
Anto has forgotten
Anto,
this was
I
a thing.
Anto, I think, came back once.
Yeah, these are new.
Oh, Splatoon, he's had there for a while.
Oh, really?
You know why? You know why they are in there? Because we were literally driving here one day. I'm like, dude, get your phone out. I'll tell you how to make bids. And he was like, all right. And he made two bids when we were in the car because I talked him through it.
So 18, he lost on Last of Us.
And that's what I lost in the... this one. Oh, wait. No, that's the wrong year. 2022. Yeah.
I was going to say, we got a winner already?
I came second in that one as well.
Give it a second.
Ding, 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 ding.
Let's check the
ding,
Discord because we don't have it open at the moment.
Ding, ding,
that's not.
Oh, Dylan. It's all right.
What?
Post fake news to lead to review bombing of each other's games.
Should kind of pick Arceus like the cool kid.
It's still backwards.
Oh, yeah. I'm just reading what they're writing in the chat.
Oh,
here.
Okay.
Good call with the Alex Mack callback.
Alex Mack?
Mm-hmm. Fortnite now, you can turn into a silver blob.
Alex Mack?
Alex Mack.
Brie Larson in...
Yep. She's Paradigm.
Yeah. Very random. Okay.
All right. Let's have a look at this bad boy.
Oh, wait, I've got to zoom back out for a sec.
So I think it's going to be hard for anyone to beat Triple Indy.
Yeah.
Like, he's projected to have 91.
And is already at 87. And they've got two games coming out still.
Yep. And like, so unless they bomb. So second place, I think, is at the moment, Mike Towns is on 78.
Yep.
And that's projected. Like, it's going to be super hard to beat Triple Indy.
Yeah.
Who's in lead at the moment? Triple Indy.
Triple Indy on both accounts.
Who's second?
Yeah. In actual. But again, you're...
That's actually second.
That's all you're getting. You got nothing to look forward to.
Whoa, I must have lost. Did I lose a lot on this or what?
Yeah, I think you've got a couple of zeros in there.
Let's have a look. Well, we'll take it in turns.
So Nintendvania, he's, again, I think he's jumped ship.
Well, they've clearly dropped something early on.
Yeah, that was Breath of the Wild 2.
Okay.
He was in the chat today.
Oof.
Yeah, I know. I was surprised.
And
then Hogwarts, he's got a zero on because it's not coming out this year.
Yep.
Triple Indie.
Okay, Elden Ring.
Yeah, so
okay.
Anyone who picked Elden Ring this year,
King of Fighters
very
got 80.
Much just win.
Well, nice work on King of Fighters.
See, one thing I've noticed, Triple Indy and Game Boy Dad are really good at picking obscure games that
never
get
heard of
real high scores.
Mm.
Oh, this was that the Rhythm Doom.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, yeah. Like Cadence of Hyrule.
Yeah.
I would not have picked that to do well.
Points. So, yeah, unless... Some of these games bomb. I don't see him.
Like, never heard of it. And it got, like, 9 points.
It's ridiculous, isn't it?
Game Boy Games. So he's still got Bayonetta. He's still got Hellblade. And he's still got River City Girls too.
Yeah,
and
so I don't
Sonic Mania 2.
I'm pretty sure River City Girls was announced as not coming out this year.
It would have changed on there.
It says estimated. I'm hearing Discord messages. So let's quickly double check and see what's up.
That's just Townsy gloating.
Nintendo.
What have I got? So yeah, that Kirby Dream Buffet.
Dream Buffet. That's a
Dream
terrible
Buffet.
Name.
What the fuck is that?
That was that Fall Guys ripoff.
They did a Fall Guys ripoff.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
Yeah, you can buy it.
Oh yikes! Oh no. Oh, how quickly did they pump that out?
Yeah, it was quick.
Took 7 minutes.
That's cringe. That's cringy.
I've seen children being birthed that took longer than the development of that.
Yeah.
Jesus. Funny enough, they look the same.
17 hours, done.
Yeah, so I reckon Rabbids, I'll get a 74.
Yeah, I think that's a 7 to an 8 game.
What else we got? The Trek to Yomi I was disappointed in.
Yeah.
That was going to get more. How good was my call about the Pokemon Next Gen? Oh, yeah.
Very good call.
I wouldn't have put that in there.
And then I've got the Dragon Quest game because there's nothing else.
Yeah, when I was scouring through, So Dylan was doing super well, and then Saints Row fucked him.
Mm-hmm.
And
Shredder's Revenge
did really well.
Oh. It is a shame.
How are you going there, Braden?
Let's scroll down and see. Total War. bringing in my highest amount of points.
Yeah, damn. Well, that Last of Us, though.
Games. Yeah, that Last of Us absolutely
just counteracts everything cool about Warhammer 4. Yeah.
Really? I'm quite sad that we haven't gotten a new Playdead game announced yet.
What?
Playdead, Limbo and Inside.
Oh, okay, yes.
Well, it's because they re-released
Inside.
Yeah. So that's probably what they would have been working on.
Yeah, I was hoping they would announce something new. This one I threw in here.
Ghostbusters, Spirits Unleashed.
So I had one of the members of the local Ghostbusters fan club cosplay people call me. Mm. And they're like, oh, we've all pre-ordered at different stores. Is it okay if we come in costume? And I was like, dude, it's totally cool. You want photos, man? I'm down.
You That's know they're at the comic fair a lot.
I did not know that.
Yeah, you see them walking around?
Oh, no, I did know that. Yes. Yeah, cool. So the head Ghostbuster dude's coming to my work.
It's pretty rad. Then who else we got there in the old... That's Anto again.
Oh, no.
Does not care.
Whoops.
RoboSoft. That's We Are Robots. He got the Callisto Protocol.
Mm.
Damn. I think I made a bid on that one. And Crossfire X really messed him up.
Oh,
minus 17. Jeez.
What even is that? Free to play.
And no. I think, like, it's minus 17, but...
It's more than that.
That's more than...
Oof.
Yeah, that's what, 28?
Yeah, it should be minus 28. So that's a good thing.
Yeah, wow.
Oh, yikes. Oh, that's a good pickup.
What do you get there? Tales from the Borderlands.
Oh, nice.
Did you guys ever play the first Tales of the Borderlands? It was really good.
Very cool.
And then he's trying... Are you letting him have GoldenEye?
Yeah.
Oh, he wins.
Dude, he's on minus -4.
If he beats me,
he's on minus -4 and he's got Bayonetta 3 as his
counter. Oh,
okay. It'll do terrible. You watch.
All right, what do we got? Aphrenix has just come out of the bloody starter's den. What?
Yep. Bam. Bam.
Yeah, Bam. Cult of Lamb and Splatoon 3 really did well for her.
Mm. They did very well.
And Plague Tale. Plague Tale should do all
right. Plague Tale. Yeah, I reckon the 80s. People great. Very much liked that first one.
Yeah. Oh, son of a gun.
All right. Floppy.
Yep.
Look at Floppy go.
Pokemon Arceus.
Sifu.
Tom Clancy again.
Moss Book 2 did well.
Good call.
Sure did.
I had that in ours.
Good work.
And then Forza's out.
Didn't, even though it's due for one this year.
No, that's right, because they did the other Forza, didn't they?
Yeah, they did the wrong one.
Mm. Rollerdrome. Good work.
That did well.
Switch Sports. Still, I can't believe that was only one.
Mm. Oh, it's better than nothing.
Yeah.
Got Avatar, which now isn't coming out this year.
Till next year.
Which is good.
And a safe counter pick of my pick of Kerbal Space Program.
Pretty sure that was never coming out. And
I totally thought it was coming out.
And then Game Boy Dad?
Kirby and the Forgotten Land. Kirby and the Forgotten Title.
That's the Kirby.
Because that's the title we forgot.
Yes.
Oh, yeah.
The Forgotten Title. Oh. Interesting.
Ooh. High on life. That's the Game Boy Dad pays real close attention to this. Real close attention. Because he's added all them in very recently.
Mm.
But that... what's that one that got minus 7?
Cereal Cleaners.
Is that like a power wash sim thing?
Probably.
Yes. Top-down stealth action game where you get to experience being a murder scene cleaner for the mob in the 90s.
See, that sounds...
What like is wrong with Game Boy Dad?
That sounds like it would do good stuff.
Oh, fucking YouTube. Jesus. Damn it.
You bloody kids.
And that's it.
Yeah.
There's the update.
So there we go. That'll be fun when we find out what's going on.
Yeah.
I'm still waiting for a WrestleQuest date. They said summer, and that should be any time now. Anyway. Thanks for listening, guys. Watching. Appreciate you. Love you. You're amazing. Thank you. Say hi to your mum for me.
Have a good night.
And say hi to your mum for me.
Say hi to your mother for me.
And say thanks to your mum for me.